Welcome to Modati College of Education. I am a tutor for today's lesson, the difference between the preposition in and are the preposition on. And there was a huge debate upon the usage of these two prepositions. And I can understand why there was a confusion, because these two prepositions are very often confused, because we are not sure as when to use it grammatically in the right way. And today we are going to discuss about the difference between the in and on. The first one thing and the first one criteria is, what is the difference between in and when you use the preposition in? Alright? Something in an enclosed space. What do you mean by enclosed space? Alright? Do you see this? This is a box. In a box, only certain amount of things can be contained, because it has a physical limitation and moreover it has an enclosed space, and that's why an enclosed space means. Let's take an example, that is, she is in her room. Why do I say only in her room and not on her room? Because we are talking about an enclosed space, that is room. Your room is enclosed by four walls and you can't do anything out of your room because it has a physical limitations, and therefore I use the preposition in. When I say she is in her room, I'm using the preposition in because it has a physical limitations or it has a physical boundary. And the good thing about the using of this preposition in is, you can also use this preposition in a virtual space or a virtual limitation. Let's take an example. I have three messages in my inbox. When you have three messages, you don't say, I have three messages on my inbox. You say, I have three messages in my inbox. Because we are talking about an inbox being an enclosed space, but not a physical space like a room or a box has. We are talking about an inbox being an enclosed space. And in an inbox, only certain number of messages can be contained in your inbox at one point of time, because it has a virtual limitation to it. And therefore, I use the preposition in and not on. And on contrary to this, we have another preposition, that is on. The meaning of this on is surface, a position above or outside an area. Surface, okay, like a surface, a position above or outside an area. Let's take an example. Charlie had a tattoo on his arm. Why do you say on or not in or? Because whatever you do on your arm, or any kind of art that you can do on your arm, is going to be done on a surface. So I use the preposition on. And what about the position above? So let's take example, that is, they sat on the bench. Here also I use the preposition on, because we are talking about a position above. They sat in the position on the bench, above the bench and not under the bench, because I use the preposition on. However, I could change the sentence a little bit, that they sat on the bench in the garden. Here, on the bench shows that the position above. And I could change the sentence little bit, that in the garden he says about an enclosed space, that is a it has a physical limitation. So I use the preposition in this example. So this is a major difference between the preposition on and in. Yes. Today we learnt about the two prepositions, that is in and on. In is used in an enclosed space, and on is used in a surface, a position above or outside an area. I hope you have much more understanding of this class, and thank you for this opportunity. Thank you.